The Big Blue had threatened to erupt into one. It was inevitable in the one-all draw that someone would be sent off. Question is, how wasn't it for Melbourne Victory?
This is out of order. Yeah. It is seriously out of order. And how Costa Barbarossa stayed on the field for this, there is no way a player of his ability should have missed that ball. That is, I'm going over the top and it's a leg breaker. You can't do it. I mean, here's Guy Finkler a few weeks ago and, look, we'll see it from a different angle and he's a little bit lazy. He leaves his boot in there, but that's another one that was dangerous as well. And I think Melbourne have been probably a little bit fortunate in both of those Big Blues to have finished the game with a full complement of players on the park.
Sydney FC did well to grab a point with only 10 men themselves, which may go some way to explaining Fahid Ben Kalfalar's frustration post-match. Now, no one likes the yellow flavour, but sadly, and perhaps unbeknown to Fahid, there were several red ones in there as well. Numbers of the week, and in scoring his first goal of his second stint with Sydney, David Carney obliterated an A-League record. Since scoring his last one for the Sky Blues back in 2006, Carney had gone 3,397 days between goals for the same club, which, as you would imagine, tops the list 3 years ahead of Nick Ward. Since Carney's last Sydney goal, Australia has had five prime ministers. We interrupt Numbers of the Week to bring you Matthew Conger in Man Getting Hit by Football.
Made pretty good contact, I have to say. Matthew Conger, a little bleary-eyed here.
Newcastle had left Gosford with a headache after 11 straight visits. It had been over 8 years since they'd won there. However, the Jets finally broke a derby drought that stretched back to January 2008 with a 1-0 victory. And in doing so, the Jets consigned the Central Coast to a horrible record. The Mariners have set a new mark for consecutive matches without a clean sheet. It's now 23. And as you can see, at this rate, they'll set a new mark for goals conceded in a season. They've let in 50 in 21 games. Speaking of records, if Adelaide gets something out of their trip to Wellington this week, the Reds will make it a club-best 14 matches unbeaten. And they kick off our top three goals of the week.
Mork, clever, Thirio, cut back, Kamau! Bruce Kamau is on fire! And this exciting young winger gets his first at Cooper Stadium.
To Bridge, advantage being played. Now Santelab, the super sub! He's done it again! Brendan Santelab off the bench to put the Wanderers in front with five to go.
Western Sydney have opened up a two-point gap, but it's Adelaide now second, and there are now just 6 points between City in fourth and Newcastle in eighth. Victory in Sydney hanging on to the top six, and the latter have an enormous Champions League match at home to reigning Asian champions Guangzhou Evergrande. That's on Channel 505 at 7:30pm Wednesday, with Victory's match in Japan against Gamba Osaka on 502 from 8:55. Six rounds remain in the A-League for Season 11 and the competition is as wide open as we've ever seen it. Catch the run-in on your home of football, Fox Sports.